life cycle assessment, we said that was a technique to assess environmental impacts associated with all stages of a product, from raw material to recycled material. And use cases, we cited the EcoLeaf label. It gives you CO2 emissions produced in emissions of producing the material, and including that information in your BIM element definition, and you can pull that in your LEED documentation, right? The measurable performance is your competitive advantage in emerging on green markets, better image for the organization, and influence on legislative and pre-normative processes. The assessment metrics are complying with ISO 14,020, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, and so forth. So you get environmental labels or self-declared labels that you can use to do that. How many of those do you use? Okay? Pre-construction issue resolution. So that's a resolution of issues prior to commencement of construction. So in those situations, you use BDC, make sure you have a execution plan. And of course, you consult all your construction, all your contractual documents, which include AIA, A201, or the construction docs, all those. The use case would be MVP or trade coordination in general, and visualization and site logistics would be use cases. The measurable performance are the measured number of RFIs and the more resulting in more efficient construction, reduction in duration, and all that. The assessment metrics are reduction in RFIs and no claims. Okay, and the model validation, you want a reliable model for intended purposes, which is construction in this case. And in the test case, it could be code validation, so you can program Solibri, for example, go through the model, or you can do Dynamo to grade the model, John. Energy analysis, structural analysis, you can use the model for your safety validation. And the measurable performance is in terms of the QAQC results. And assessment metrics are the rule sets you develop for model evaluation. The last one is aggregate the model, which is establish a policy for how you put all these create a larger model using all the submodels, and the use case would be BIM 360 Glue. That's where you're going, or Navisworks. That's where you're going to integrate all your models. The measurable performance is the number of submodels integrated into the aggregate model, how much of the information is included in the whole model, and the size of the model for use. If the model gets too big, you might blow up your computer, so you can use it. Assessment metrics are processing speed of the models, the size of the model, and the visibility of specific objects in the model. The cloud, of course, eliminates a lot of these, but you still have some of them. That's it?
Great.
Any general? There was only two of us, we didn't argue.
Great.
She would win anyway, so I'm going to argue.
Anything to add, Debar?
Oh, no.
That's it?
That's it.
Great. Awesome.